I would like to show you three whistles. These are a stock, out of the box, untweaked, key of D generation whistle. This is a Jerry Freeman tweaked key of D generation whistle. And this is a Jerry Freeman tweaked Bluebird, which started its life as a key of D generation, but is tweaked much similar to the tweaked generation, but voiced a little differently, voiced a little bit more toward the pure, sweet, bird-like end, a little bit less husky sounding in the voicing. And a couple of things to point out here. The out-of-the-box generation whistle comes with the whistle head glued on, and typically they're not in tune when they come out of the box, and you have to get the whistle head off, which is a bit of a project, and then ream out the inside of the socket a little bit so that you're able to move it on the tone body so that you can actually tune it. And also, when I tweak these, I remove about 1/8 of an inch from the top of the whistle head because as they're manufactured, to get it in tune, the tone body is all the way as far as it can go up into the socket, and you don't have any leeway at all if you want to tune a few cents sharper than that. So I modify the top of the tone body so that that's possible. And of course, my whistles are fully tunable and easy to move the whistle head as I provide them. I'd like to show you the differences in how they play and how they sound. So I'll start with the stock untweaked key of D generation and just play up the scale a little bit so you can hear that. Now the lower register sounds pretty good. There really isn't a problem with that. It's mainly in the upper register that you start to have a little bit ragged sounding and harder to play cleanly. Now I'll play a tune for you, and I apologize in advance for I'm not a performer, I'm not a musician. I'll do the best I can. And those are the bottom part of the upper register are the most problematic notes in the untweaked whistle. Now let's see if we can compare with the tweaked whistle. Now you can hear those bottom notes of the upper register are much cleaner sounding. Now let me show you the same thing on the Bluebird. Let me warm this up just a bit first. Thank you. very clean. That has a little bit purer, more sort of bird-like sound to it. Now, the last thing I want to show you is there's a sweet spot in the breath pressure that you have to aim for with the untweaked whistle. And if you don't hit the sweet spot, then you're going to get a very ragged sound, just sort of garbage on either side of the exact breath pressure that works the best. And I can demonstrate that by just simply starting with a very soft breath and then blowing up through the break between the lower and the upper register. And you can hear that as a sort of a transition between the registers, which that's very ragged sounding. And that's the source of a lot of the problems with the untweaked whistles. This is the untweaked generation. This is the tweaked generation. And this is the bluebird. And it bears mention, one of the things about my whistles is that you have some dynamic range. In other words, you can lean into the notes a little bit, or you can hold back a little bit. So you actually can vary the volume somewhat, which you can't do on a lot of tin whistles. It also just makes them much easier to play because you're not constrained to one very small range of breath pressure to get a serviceable note. You can push the note or hold back a little bit. Now, if I may, I'd like to show you what these sound like when they're played by a competent musician. The first sound clip is Kevin Crawford playing a key of D, Freeman tweaked generation. And the second is L.E. McCullough playing a Freeman tweaked Bluebird. He's playing a tune that he wrote, Freeman's tweaked Bluebird is the title, in recognition of Yarla McMahon, who as a 10-year-old won the All-Ireland tin whistle competition playing a Freeman tweaked Bluebird. So the Bluebird has actually won the All-Ireland competition, which is noteworthy, and I thought you might like to know.
Tweaked D whistle.
I'm sorry. there